80 mile an hour and he wouldn't back out of it. What an absolute moron. That's why I keep talking about me. There's no need for it.
I'm gonna rob it.
middle passing. Absolutely awesome. Look at that beautiful bit of driving. That's a true professional right there. Look at that. Awesome. Good lad.
Oh my God.
30 minutes spare. Now I've only got 15 minutes spare. Thank you. only thing I give my truck up for is to have something like that. I would love a Volvo. I think Volvo's awesome. I have too many bad stories about their engines consistently having problems and breaking down all the time. And I hope Scania doesn't go the same way, but he was saying they got, I forgot to tell you this, there was a, I've been riding on lorry interiors past and present on Facebook. And there's a gentleman on there that commented and said that he spoke to an international dealer, a salesman, and he said they got the Scania engine in it. Said some of them have already got the 426 cylinder engine in them, and they're getting great fuel consumption out of them at the moment, and they seem pretty reliable. Well, of course, we're all waiting for, as you can imagine, the inevitable V8 to come out and come over here, which would pretty interesting, because I truly would like to have one. It's not the Scania itself, the truck, but that is one hell of a V8, and it is basically based on, I know the car was way off the shoulder, but I moved over to the left a little, and then I had turn signal back over to the right, which confused myself. But so the V8 is a hell of a motor. It is a hell of a motor. It's got so much down torque. Low torque on them, sorry. So the rev range is right down the bottom, and the grunt on them is amazing, and that's what I really like about them. I wouldn't say Scania's a great truck. I don't think it's a shy truck, I think it's a very nice truck, but I wouldn't say it was a great truck all around. It has its flaws, like everything else does in this world. See, yet again, you get beside me and then you slow down. I don't get it. So yes, even a six-cylinder will probably be a nice engine. I just don't know how well they perform at the moment over here, or if they'd be underpowered. Everything goes on torque anyway. But I always said that if International got them and they come out with the V8s, and I don't know how I would afford it, or if I could even make it possible, but I would definitely have a go, and I would trade mine off to have one with a V8 engine in it. I think that would be freaking awesome. I just don't know if they would fit them in them or not, because the turbo sits on the back side, and I wonder if they'd have to reconfigure the way the turbo sits. Be interesting though. So I'm going to look into that a little bit and see where they're at the moment. And like I said, I'd like a Volvo. I think Volvos are awesome. That's just because as I'm classed out here, European, which I'm not, but I'm kidding. But yeah, I would love one as well. They're extremely comfortable, but they just have too many problems. I don't know what the new ones are like, but they don't have about $180,000 for a brand new one, which I think is absolutely freaking insane. Unless you're getting about 12, 13 miles to the gallon. That is an extortionate amount of money. I'd still keep my Caterpillar. Imagine how many European, Eastern European